the Middleton-Cross Plains Area School District. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Chloe.
And I'm Caleb. Let's take a quick look at what has been going on around our amazing district.
Clark Street students went to a small pottery local studio called Twin Valley Clay. Check out this footage.
Hi, I'm Caleb. I'm here at Clark Street. Just here to talk about a cool field trip that they went on. I'm here with Luke. And first of all, what is Twin Valley Clay?
Well, Twin Valley Clay is just a little shop where she makes clay pottery, cups and pots, and just other cool stuff like that.
What did you make?
I made a pot, I guess. It's pretty much get a whole chain or something in my car so it doesn't go everywhere. And I also made a hand. I carved out my hand, and I know I did that in like first grade, so I thought it would be like a pretty good gift for my mother or something like that.
What do you think was unique about the studio?
When you first walked in, you kind of immediately saw the artwork that other people had done. There was a lot of little clay figures that you can tell were made by people who weren't necessarily knowing what they were doing, and you saw also really impressive pieces of pottery, and that was really interesting to see all the sort of people who might have walked in.
On Friday, January 23rd, Middleton High School boys basketball hosted Coaches versus Cancer game. It was an exciting game, and in only 83 seconds during the bucket pass, they raised over $2,000. Not including t-shirt sales, which were sold out, the grand total with Wall of Hope cards and Luminaria was $3,845.86. This is unheard of for a Coaches versus Cancer game. And please come out to the girls' basketball game on February 10th. They have set a goal to raise over $5,000. Let's bring that total even higher.
We want to give a shout out to Elm Lawn, which had 2 fourth graders that recently won a national writing competition. Congratulations!
My name is Deb Dagus. I'm the librarian here at Elm Lawn Elementary School, and I'm so excited that we had 2 students from our school in fourth grade who were chosen as winners of a national writing project. We found out about this project, or I found out, through a former fifth grade teacher, Pernille Riff. And she connected us with Mrs. P, who nationally does a writing contest. The fourth grade classes were all invited to Skype with her, and she talked a little bit about imagination and writing. And then the fourth grade teachers promoted the writing contest, which was done from their own time. And the students could either write a whole class project or individual. And I believe in Mrs. Close's class, the group decided to vote on the story that ended up being chosen. So it came about from another colleague recommending it, and I'm so excited that students here at Elm Lawn won.
So I wrote a story about 2 kids using a magic baseball poster to see Jackie Robinson and the day before he went into the major leagues. What inspired me to write about this is that I read a book about Jackie Robinson, and the contest was about time travel. So I made an object to use to go back in time and see Jackie Robinson in person. So we saw a webcast, and our library teacher, Mrs. Dagus, just webcasted like the person, Mrs. P, that like, created the contest, so it was really good.
It's a great honor because when I wrote the story and I won my class, I didn't think like I would win the whole national honor, and so yeah, it's a great honor. Yeah, I liked writing before too, so.
David Whittingham, an eighth grader at Cromrie, won the MCPASD Spelling Bee on Wednesday, January 21st at the Performing Arts Center. Approximately 60 students in grades 4 through 8, all of whom won school bees, participated in the three-hour district event. Glacier Creek sixth grader Lauren Poling finished in second place. The top 8 students are eligible to compete at the Regional Spelling Bee in Stoughton on March 4th. Students who finished in 9th through 12th place are alternates.
More than 300 tickets have been sold out for the Maggie May concert to honor Rod Peanuts Esser at the Performing Arts Center on April 18th. MCPASD Education Foundation Peanuts will be celebrating the 50 years as a custodian at Park Elementary School. Tickets for the show, which begins at 7 p.m., are $26 for orchestra seating and $21 for mezzanine seating. All seats are reserved. Tickets can be purchased through Brown Paper Tickets website or by calling 1-800-838-3006. Again, 1-800-838-3006. All ticket proceeds from the event will benefit the MCPASD Education Foundation.
Camp Invention will be held at Sauk Trail for the second consecutive summer, this time from July 13th through the 17th. The camp runs from 9 a.m. until 3:30 p.m. all 5 days and is open to students in grades 1 through 6. The camp costs $230, although discounts are available. Camp Invention is where big ideas become the next big thing. Local educators lead the week of hands-on activities created especially for younger children. Boys and girls spend time pushing the limits during high-energy games, working with teammates to construct a freestyle racing cart, and taking apart electronics to assemble something one of a kind. Lessons explore connections between science, technology, engineering, and innovation. For information, call 1-800-968-4332. That's 1-800-968-4332. Or visit the Camp Invention website.
On January 29th, Middleton High School duct-taped Mr. Vervoort, a band teacher here at MHS, to a wall at lunch to raise money for the Global Outreach Sadie Hawkins Dance. Woo, woo!
How do you feel up on the wall today, Mr. Vervoort?
I feel same as I always do. It doesn't feel that different.
The dance is happening on February 13th, and all proceeds will be going towards Open Roads, a Romanian orphan outreach organization. Ticket sales begin February 4th.
Yeah. More than 100 Clark Street Community School students presented their presentations of learning on January 22nd or 23rd. Students had the option of a formal public speaking presentation, roundtable discussion, or poster presentation. The students reflected on their learning experience from the past semester, or a summary or a project that they participated in during the fall. The presentations were open to fellow students, families, school staff, and community partners.
Difficult than I thought it was going to be, because I was raised up 11 years of almost corrupt education. I don't know if that's the right word for it, but it was a big struggle for me. But
when you do it and you actually engage in it, they can be really insightful, and you can actually, if you look back far enough and really dig into your past or past experiences here, you really understand and you really get a grasp of, you know, what this school is about. And, you know, how you can grow, and you can actually grow much more as a learner and as a personal person than you would, I feel like, anywhere else. So, I mean, it's really, really eye-opening for yourself and for the school.
It was incredibly powerful and sometimes emotional to see and hear the students share their experiences. Clark Street Principal Jill Gertner told the Board of Education at its meeting on January 26th, seniors John Griffith, who is in his first year at Clark Street, and Emily Zenz wholeheartedly agreed.
Education Foundation President Courtney Ward Reichard and board member Shauna Bertalot stopped by Northside on January 23rd to celebrate with art teacher Betsy Delzer, who had a donor buy a classroom sign in her honor. Northside principal Roz Craney was also on hand.
So I'd started thinking about some quotes that felt representative of my teaching philosophy. And the quote from Vincent Van Gogh about really loving people and that being truly the most artistic thing felt like it summed up why I do what I do. And that is to be in connection and in community with the kids and to create a beautiful process. So our art making that happens every day at Northside is really centered on the connection that we experience and the process of finding ourselves knee and elbow deep in creativity and in sort of mess making, and that ends up being an ultra beautiful process in creating beautiful art. This sign is really not about me, you know, it's about this community and what is happening every day with kids and in their process of growing, in their process of learning, that. So it was a kind of a quiet moment. You know, I was here in the hallway by myself and saw it being installed and just sat with the words and sat with sort of the meaning. And it was humbling and very honoring.
More than 20 signs have been purchased by individuals and businesses to honor loved ones or a favorite staff member. Signs cost $1,500 and up and will remain in place for 10 years.
Also at MHS is our featured artist, Dino Maniachi. Maniachi has a diverse career and currently teaches graphic design at Madison College. In Gallery 2000 are many examples of his design work for those interested in checking out this featured talent.
What I did was actually create sort of a chart of the process. For those of us who are artists, we start with the big idea. For a graphic designer, the big idea often starts with a client asking you to do something. So whether it's design a poster or a package or a product or an ad, we start with the concepting part of the project. We explore, we research, we define, experiment, play, invent, access, and finally create. So really coming up with the ideas and then putting them into process. The process then becomes the production of the idea. These are examples of some packaging and some product development that I've done over the years. Everything from developing the content for children's educational materials, that included hiring illustrators and photographers to create the content, designing the packaging so that the people see it in the store and are inspired to buy it. And in these cases, developing some really fun products for the Frank Lloyd Wright Foundation to help sell some of his work in the sense of rubber stamps and posters and magnets for the Museum of Modern.
That'll do it for this edition of In Review. Stay Middleton mighty.
And Cross Plains classy.
Bye.
Nice.